طيب، we reached to the point about we are talking about the Sahaba, and this is very important. Now, what we should understand, the companions are human beings. They are not angels. Okay, but they are the best people after prophets, alayhim salatu wasalam. Alaykum salam. Do they have mistakes? Yes, they have mistakes. Okay, did they do major mistakes? Yes, they did major sins. They did major sins. You need pen? So they did major mistakes. Yani, as it came in the sharh, some of the companions did major sins like drinking khamr, adultery, fornication, stealing. Okay, they did major mistakes. Okay, and still they are sahaba. And we should know that, I mean, many people cannot absorb that if the how come they are companions and they do major mistakes? Okay, because they are human beings. And also now, many people, many Muslims don't accept or they cannot absorb that, wallah, he is a sheikh and also he is doing mistakes. Yes, this is possible. Of course, this is not allowed. It is haram for the Muslim, he is sheikh or he is a normal Muslim, to do mistakes. It is haram, I mean, intentionally, to commit a major sin or minor sin. This is haram. But this is possible. It is happening. How come you are sheikh and you did this? Of course, you are sheikh and you did this mistake. Of course, this is wrong. But if he is sheikh, it doesn't mean he is a malak, an angel. Okay? So this is the point here. If they are companions, they did mistakes, but as we mentioned last week or before 2 weeks, Allah forgive their mistakes. Why? Because they did a lot of good deeds. They prayed with the Prophet ﷺ, they fought with him in the jihad, they traveled with him, they lived with him, sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Okay? So what he said, Shaykh Islam Taymiyyah, we reached to the point, and it came in an authentic hadith that they are the best. Khayrul Qurun. Alaykum salam. They are the best people. The best among people. Khayrul Qurun. The Prophet said in the authentic hadith, Khayrul Nas. Look, the word here, Nas. What does it mean, Nas? People. He did not say the best among us people. So it means they are better than the people of Musa, the people of Isa, who are called Al-Hawariyun. Who are Al-Hawariyun? Isa alayhi salam, followers and supporters. The close friends of Isa alayhi salam, called Al-Hawariyun. Who is better? The companions or the Hawariyun? The Sahaba. Why? Because the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Khayru an-nas, the word an-nas, general. Okay? وَأَنَّ الْمُدَّ مِنْ أَحَدِهِمْ. What's mean mud? Full of the two hands. This is called mud. Okay? If they give mud, full of the two hands, as a charity, okay, it is better than a mountain of us. For example, if I give a mud, a full of hands, dates, how much? Maybe half kilo, 1 kilo, okay? If for example, if Abu Bakr or Umar, Uthman, they give one handful of dates, rice, it is better than me if I give a mountain of dates, tons and tons, okay? Why? Because the Prophet ﷺ said this. Okay, then Shaykh Islam Taymiyyah said, if there is a sin from them, فَيْكُونْ قَدْ تَابَ مِنْ, then he made a tawbah, repentance. Okay. Now, what he's talking about, as I mentioned in the last halqa, he's talking about the sins of the Sahaba. Because now, you'll find the bad people, the evil people, okay, they try to attack the companions. They want to show us the mistakes of the companions. Okay? So, Shaykh Islam Taymiyyah said, suppose they did a sin. Okay? So, he did the repentance. He repented after the sin. Or he did many hasanat, it means many good deeds after the sin. Okay, now what is the relation? Doing many hasanat after the good, after the sin. What is the relationship? Good deeds will? Yes, the good deeds will wipe, will erase, will remove the bad deeds. As Allah mentioned this in Surah Hud, إِنَّ الْحَسَنَاتِ يُذْهِبْنَ السَّيِّئَاتِ. The good deeds will wipe the bad deeds, the sins. Or Allah forgave them because they accepted Islam at the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. No doubt, there is a big difference between the companions who accepted Islam at the beginning of da'wah and who became Muslim later. And many times we mention the hadith about Abdul Rahman ibn Auf and Khalid ibn Walid. Who accepted Islam before? Abdul Rahman ibn Auf. He accepted Islam at the beginning of da'wah. Maybe the first week or the first month. And Khalid ibn Walid? Or during the conquest of Mecca. يعني about 20 years after عبد الرحمن بن عوف رضي الله تعالى عنهم أجمعين. Okay. And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said to Khalid Walid and to everyone, don't insult my companions. Khalid Walid, one of his companions, and also عبد الرحمن بن عوف, with the friendship and the relationship between the Prophet ﷺ and Abdul Rahman Auf, no doubt, is much stronger than the relationship between the Prophet ﷺ and Khalid Walid, and both of them companions. So what about us and Khalid Walid and Abdul Rahman Auf? There is a big difference. Or because of the intercession of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Now he's mentioning that there is a point that they did a sin. Okay. Don't focus only on this point. Well, he had a sin. He did the sin. Okay, but you don't forget, number one, he did tawbah, he did repentance. Number two, he did many good deeds, so he erased and wiped the bad deeds. Number three, he became Muslim before us. He is a companion. Number four, the Prophet ﷺ has the intercession. He has the right to intercede. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave the Prophet Muhammad ﷺ, okay, the right of intercession, shafa'ah, wasta, intercession. Okay? Who deserves the shafa'ah more? We or the companions? The companions of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So this is number four, the intercession. Number five, or ubtuliya bi bala'. Allah test him with some calamity, then Allah forgive him. Because as you know, subhanallah, any calamity will raise your sins. The Prophet ﷺ mentioned in the hadith, ما يصيب المسلم من نصب ولا وصب ولا هم حتى الشوكة يشاكوها. This is a great hadith, wallahi. Great hadith. Maybe this hadith equals to, or not equals, it is stronger than the psychiatrist. If you understand and absorb this hadith, the Prophet ﷺ mentioned, any nasab, what's mean nasab? Tiredness. Wasab. What's what wasab? Disease. Hem. What does it mean of hem? No, not sadness. Concern. Concern. Like what? Tomorrow I have exam. How the exam will be difficult or not. Or for example, tomorrow you have an interview for a job, new job. So at the night you think, okay, or what will happen to this issue? So you think, concern. or the Prophet ﷺ even a thorn. All of these things, what will do? All these things will remove from your sins. إلا كفر الله بهم سيئاته. Can you imagine this? Sometimes there is an issue. Subhanallah, this issue comes to you at night. You cannot sleep, or you delay your sleep because of thinking of this issue. Allah will forgive your sins. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. طيب. So Shaykh Islam Taymiyyah said, Allah, okay, test them with some calamity, so Allah forgive their sins. So he said, فَإِذَا كَانَ هَذَا فِي الذُّنُوبِ مُحَقَّقٍ. So now we are talking about if really they did a sin. Okay, so what about the issues that they did ijtihad? He said, these 5 points, if really they did a sin. Okay, so now, what about if they did not do a sin, but they did ijtihad? What is the meaning of ijtihad? Yeah, and there was an issue. They are not sure this is haram or halal, allowed or not allowed. Then they start to bring the proofs from the Quran and Sunnah. Then they came to a conclusion that this is haram, or this is wajib, this is mustahab. So this is meaning of ijtihad. So he said, if it is ijtihad, and they did not catch the correct opinion. So do you think that every sheikh does an ijtihad, he will catch the correct opinion? No. Many times they will not do the correct opinion. Okay? So if they catch the correct opinion, Allah will give them two rewards. One reward of ijtihad, and the second reward of getting the correct opinion. Okay, if they did not get the correct opinion, Allah will give them one reward because of what? Ijtihad. Because they worked hardly to find the correct opinion, but they did not get the correct answer. Alaykum salam. So Allah will give them the reward. So why you blame them and Allah will give them reward? So sometimes, okay, we blame a sheikh. Look, the sheikh, he said this is haram. Okay, why you blame him? Allah gave him reward because he did ijtihad, and this is his his proofs from the Quran and Sunnah. He reached to this opinion. So he said this is haram. Allah gave him reward, and now you are blaming him. Don't blame him. This is not allowed. Okay? Then what Shaykh Islam Taymiyyah said, okay, that إن القدر الذي ينكر من فعل بعضهم, okay, now you are, as I said, he is trying Shaykh Islam Taymiyyah, or he is defending the companions, because look what Muawiyah did, and Amr ibn al-As, Abu Huraira, Ali ibn Abi Talib, رضي الله تعالى عنهم أجمعين, okay, so he said, now you are focusing on very little, few mistakes from some of them. Okay? If you compare what they did of the mistakes with what they did of good deeds, then the mistakes, nothing. Yeah, and for example, maybe somebody will bring a situation from Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, radiallahu ta'ala an. Okay? Yes, Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, he did a mistake. So don't focus on this mistake. Why? Because you'll find, on the other hand, many, okay, ahadith. The Prophet ﷺ said, Abu Bakr in the paradise. Abu Bakr is the best. Abu Bakr. Okay, so why you focus on one dot and you forget pages of good deeds? This is unfair. But subhanAllah, this is the way of the evil people. Okay, they try to focus and to talk only about the negative. And this is not the way of the Muslim. This is not the way of the Muslim. يعني سبحان الله, what is the way of the Muslim? There is hadith, okay, it This is not related to the topic, but to tell you